place your children into that field. And it's cute. It's cute. I haven't done one in a very long time because I have not had an age-appropriate child in a long time. My older kids are in their 20s. My middle now, but she was the baby for a long time, is she's 17. And so now I have my three-year-old, right? There's a 20-year span on children that I've given birth to. Nuts. Like, sometimes you hear the 20-year span. You're like, wow, that's crazy. But often it was, like, involved the dad getting remarried, right, to a younger woman. But no, I was just an old mom when I had my last one. So he's three, and he is, like, when you go to these things, it's kind of hard because you see all personalities come out, which is one thing. Kids will be kids, you know. Kids will be kids. And I've always tended to have a little bit of shy children. Shy to, like, moderate shy children, including this one. So you see, like, the more aggressive kids, and you're just, like, hoping that your kid can grab an egg, and at some point you do have to help them get an egg if they're, like, in this 2-3-year-old range, you know. But what's worse, that's not bad at all. I work with kids too, so I've seen it all. Obviously, I've had a bunch of kids, and I raised my siblings, so I'm no stranger to seeing kids try each other. But what I hate to watch is when I see a parent get aggressive, and it never fails at these Easter egg hunts that, like, you'll see usually a dad, okay, but sometimes an aggressive mom that isn't just out there for fun. They're out there for, like, to see how many eggs their kid can get, and, like, taking way more than their share of the eggs, okay. And some of you will be like, no, that's the name of the game. Okay, I disagree. I think, you know, you look around, you try to judge how many eggs other kids are getting, and then when your kid has about that, you're like, okay, we did it, bud, let's get out of here. It's not sports. And I will stand 10 toes down and say, a lot of the problems, and I don't know if you've been down these rabbit holes or not, or if you work in the school systems or not, a lot of the problems we're having is the parents' faults. Not all, because you can have four kids and you can have one that's a doozy, okay? You're trying to do the same thing and one's a doozy, right? But in generally speaking, yes. I was working with a group of kids the other day, and, you know, I had to line them up. This is, like, one of my jobs. I have a bunch of jobs that I do part-time. So I had to line the kids up and get them outside so they could be picked up. We're talking, we'll just say, like, maybe 8-year-olds, right? And in her pajamas, and I used to pick up my kids in pajamas sometimes too, right, from the car. But, and it's fine, it doesn't real cigarette. And the kid's like, we'll call the kid Joni. Joni runs up to her mom and she's like, Mom, that kid cut me. And the mom starts flipping out. Who cut you? Who cut you? And I'm like, do you mean that a kid cut you in line? Like they got in front of you in line? She's like, yeah. And her mom's like, okay. I got to a class a couple weeks ago, and this class was awesome. I could totally go back to this class, but I was like, hi, I'm here for, you know, Mrs. Whatever, and they're like, okay, well, we have to tell you, and I'm like, oh, God, that's not good. Whatever this is not good, that this class has not seen their own classroom for a week and a half. There is such a sub shortage that this class hasn't had their own classroom for a week and a half, so they've been championed out into other classrooms, separated and championed out into other classrooms. And can you imagine, as a parent, knowing that your kid just hasn't had a teacher in a week and a half? And sometimes longer. The list on the board of classes they still need to fill in that one building. There's been a lot of viruses going on. That one building had 15 teachers out. No, not just 15 teachers out. There's already subs there. That morning, they had 15 empty positions that had not been accepted by subs. There's a lot of reasons for this. I am in a rough city, a rough town, and it trickles down to the kids, right? A lot of behavior issues, lack of support, and then the pay. Do you think they could throw more pay at the issue so that people would take these jobs? A lot of people, actually 2/3 of the people that enter this because even though it's public school uniforms, and I don't know, but I gotta agree, I think there's plenty of ways for kids to express themselves with fashion. And, but after school, it just simplifies the process. So I pretty much wear a uniform. I have sections in my closet that are rotations for like my days off, my days working at schools, and then my days working my other jobs. Like sometimes they kind of cross over, but I do not care if somebody's seen me in this outfit 5 days. I don't care. I own a washer and a dryer. You guys know I don't care because I come on this channel in the same stuff. Get on Mercari go to work.